probably finished your worksheet, and I hope you have, and now it's time to wonder, have you got the right answers? You've checked with a partner, and maybe you've even checked around, and you feel pretty good about it. But there is one way you can check for sure. You can use the calculator on the computer. So if you haven't found the calculator before, you're going to come over here to your Start button, go to All Programs, and then just kind of scroll through your list until you find Accessories. And right there near the top, there's Calculator. So go ahead and click on it. And it's going to start like this. This is your standard view, and feel free to use your calculator anytime, do all the regular math that you need to. But there are some more options. So if you click here on View, you'll see Scientific, Programmer, Statistics. There's some interesting ones. We're going to click on Programmer, and now your calculator expands. And you'll see right here are some choices: hexadecimal, decimal, octadecimal, and binary. Well, these are the two that we've been working with, binary and decimal. If you want to experiment with hexadecimal, a lot of computers use this now, so it's pretty interesting. You can see what it's like. But let's say we start with decimal, and I'm going to put in a number, 45. And I want to see what it is in binary. I just click binary. So I can come back and I can check another number, 89, binary. So you can go through your worksheet, and for all the decimal numbers, just start with decimal, type in the number, click binary, and you can check your work. And you can also do the reverse. So I can start here in binary, I can type in my number, and click decimal, and there's the answer. So go through your worksheet and go ahead and check all your answers. And then if you want to see what hexadecimal looks like, it's going to be a little different. I'm going to start with a number and see how I get a letter in there. So that letter's going to mean something. See if you can figure it out.